adventure. To me, adventure, it conjures up the image of experiencing unknownness. So I design my own projects in the mountains, which gives me the opportunity of exploring my own inner self, wherein I would like to face fear. So that pretty much sums up the idea of adventure for me, which is to dwell into the unknownness, be it your inner self as well as the outside world of mountains. When I was very young, I studied in Sainik School, Kolkata. One of our school seniors attempted Mount Everest as part of Indian Army Expedition in 1985. Unfortunately, there was a mishap in the expedition and six of the officers lost their lives. I was very young at that time and only 11 years old. I saw the statue which was inaugurated in the school. Somehow it went into my heart that one day if I grow up and believe that I possessed courage and strength to face this mountain at any point of my life, I will not back off from this challenge. So it took me 30 years. When I was graduating out of IIM Calcutta, I opted out of the campus placements and I embarked on the journey to scale Everest. In the process, I discovered that none of the Indians have summited the seven highest peaks in the seven continents, and I felt it very fortunate to have discovered and embraced the challenge and shared it with my friends. I didn't have any companies or institutional support. So it's mostly my school alumni and college friends who had supported this. These are the seven summits. And you see eight of them, which is Carstens Pyramid. There are two versions of them, Australia and Oceania continents. I did both of them. The old record, which I did in 2006, which was bettered. But I claim that I was once a Guinness record holder. So that's what old record thing was about. So yeah, I did them, but I still cherish having submitted each of these seven summits on seven different days of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. I planned for it. So that's where my education went in probably. I mean, I allowed myself to be succumbed to the spirits of the mountains. So I kept going to these mountains every year. In the process, it became a journey of my own inner self as well. So now living in the mountains I'd done the Trans-Himalayan treks, one of which is walking across all the four dams through the mountain passes. None of the Indians have done them in one go, they did in pieces. But I did 50 days trek, and similarly another trek that I did was walking from Mount Everest to Kanchenjunga region. I started on September 16, 2008. Just after the blacks in Connaught Place, and December 16 I ended and came back. Stock market has come down to 8,000. Earlier it was in 16,000. So I came back and asked my friends what had happened. And they're like, yeah, something's happened, don't bother. Back on December 15th, my recent project is to climb the highest peak in all the 12 countries of South America continent, of which I had done 9 of them. So what is remaining is Colombia, Brazil and Suriname. These are not very highest peaks, all these three. But locally there are problems in Colombia and Brazil. And Suriname, I'm still trying to figure out the latitude and longitudes. It's deep inside the jungles of Amazon. And after that, I've tried to do the highest 10 peaks of Andes region. At the end of the day, want to choose our life depending on what is available and what is more interesting to us. So the truth is that I've been living in mountains close to 6 to 9 months. Yeah, mountains has been my way of life, and I have clarity from my side that this is the life I have chosen. I live life with projects, and through these, I relate my outdoor activities with what I see from within, the journey of my life. So to me, somehow it became transparent for me that my choice of living peace will be in the mountains. When I come back, I have friends, I do experience emotions in terms of what is
there's like, you know, sharing affection and all of those normal emotions. At the same time, to me, being in mountain, being with nature is something which I'm able to, it is more tangible for me. One of my experiences is climbing Mount Shasta, which is one of the highest peaks in California, alone on December 25. I mean, without a car, you cannot go anywhere. So I had a couple of transports. I ended up in a Mount Shasta town at Black Bear restaurant. I walked in, it was very at the end of the morning, about 2 o'clock. With the instincts of growing up in India, I walked into, I mean, those people who dropped me in the car, they dropped me at this place saying that we will be able to meet people here. So I was with my backpack, arriving there, not much of climbing gear. I didn't even have the crampons, I had the ice axe. And I say that I would like to rent out gear and also hire a guide if possible. And so they felt it as a bit ridiculous because it is December 25, Christmas season, everything will be closed. So they say that you'll be able to meet some people in this restaurant, talk to them, they'll be through the night. So I walked in, put my backpack and then sat in one of the corners. And the first thing I did when the waitress came was I ordered for a coffee, same as you ordered chai and then start the discussion. So when she came and I asked her, quietly I knew that she's going to share it with others, saying that I want to climb Shasta and I came from India. So she just said, what? And then I said, I want to climb Shasta and I came from India and I'm traveling alone. And she said, I don't think I know anybody. And then she said she's going to bring coffee and went around, and the word spread among the people. They were all waking awake through the night. One of them was working at a hospital. He works as a nurse. And he walked to me saying that, hey, I heard that you want to climb Shasta, and you know what are you into? And that was after my 7th summit. Most of the times I've been kind of not very much outspoken in terms of sharing what I did. That time I say that yes, this is my name and you can Google about myself with Google. So he found out and then I had the experience and he said, okay, you can do it. And from then on we had the conversation. He said he's going to take me to his home and he instantly showed the pictures of Shasta. And then I ended up doing and then a lot more. What I'd like to emphasize here is I did encounter some of the best people through which I also experienced best of emotions in terms of inhumanity, which is very positive feeling and also very reassuring that there is still a lot of positivity in the world. So I still enjoy traveling a lot of them alone, and then I did make my mountaineering friends in different parts of South America. Still one of my favorite continents and which I will travel the other ones. I'm sure, I mean, it is hard to choose from which place, which continent. A lot of times people ask which place, which continent. And I guess most of there will be many of them, it is hard to pick. Instead, leave them, enjoy them, and embrace all of these instead of just trying to be choose. Going for Shasta, that's when I was asking myself, I was in midwinter, harsh winter of US, and walking through the pine forest. Forest is what I'm a little bit afraid of because everything looks similar. I'd like to go higher. Wherein I'll be able to see if I see the mountain, if I can read the ridges, that makes me feel comfort. And once I go up and then look down, I'll be able to read the topography. Again, I mean, until this year, I wasn't using GPS. This year, I was climbing in Andes. A lot of them I attempted solos. And Andes mountains are different. They're volcanic. Once you go to the top, you find the crater, which is almost an equal elevation. Unlike a pointed peak, protruding to the sky, and you know clearly that that's the summit. So I would really look for a higher place, climb up, then look for where the real summit is. So I missed a couple of them. So this time, situation, in that night of Shasta, I was asking myself, I mean, like, you know, what is it making me to walk in this continent, which is not my native place? Am I not afraid of darkness and all of that? What do I want to do here? And there wasn't any, clarifying thought, but I felt that this is life. I mean, like, no, I just
you belong there, it's your home.
Yes, I belong there and I want to encounter that fear. I want to face it. I mean, like, is it the newness? Is it the unknown thing inside of me as well as outside the pine forest and the cold of that California? And after a while, it becomes a little journey. if you are able to figure it out, I think it is maybe lucky, but you don't have. I mean, to me, coming back again, some of the things have become very clear in this mountaineering field. Otherwise, see, a lot of times we have to have a crisis to understand or have a strong lessons, and it doesn't come soon. You'll have to wait for 5 years, 10 years, maybe not now. Get into that part of yourself which will not be touched or unexplored. You need those instances, and through them you grow in yourself. To me, I was fortunate that I was able to make choices wherein I was plunging myself into that domain, and I was each time for me the experience was gold. So I kept plunging in and then exploring more of my deeper self through these projects.